Brada! Hey!
Come on.
You wanna win?
Hi, my name is Tommy.
And my name is Stephanie.
And we've been together for 6 years, married for 4.
Nope.
I like that she was easy to talk to, easy to get along, and she was just as competitive as I was.
Alright, I got this one. Yes!
Ooh. What turns me on the most about Tommy is his lips. Cause they're so kissable and they're soft.
I was having sore and strep throats all the time. So the doctor said, let's get a tonsillectomy. That's gonna make you feel a lot better. Our relationship was new.
Dang.
Not so bad for my first time.
And Stephanie drove all the way down to pick me up to play nurse with me. And I never had anybody who wanted to take care of me in that way.
That's beginner's luck.
And she took me to this awesome resort that had arcade, pool, miniature golf, croquet, and a comfortable bed. I could not ask for anything more.
I feel sorry for you and your bruised ego, but I'm willing to cut you some slack since you just had your tonsils out. Best out of 3.
You know, I'd rather go back to the room and play something else.
All I wanted to do was thank Stephanie for, you know, everything that she did for me. So I asked her to go back up to the hotel.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, I really love you, babe.
I love you too.
I was very excited that my work had paid off and he was appreciative.
It's just been 3 days since your surgery. Are you sure you're ready for this?
Mm-hmm. And medically, I just thought everything was fine.
I wanted to show my gratitude, and you know, I thought the best way would to give her a lot of kisses all over. If you catch my drift.
Come here, boy.
We had a lot of fun, a lot of attention to each other. And it was a great night. I slept like a brick that night. And I woke up a little off. Something was different. You know, I had that feeling something's not right.
Oh my God. Oh no, what the?
And it wasn't the way it normally looked. I knew something wasn't right.
Tommy. Is everything okay?
It was getting pretty close to being unbearable.
Nurse, I'm in a lot of pain. My penis has swollen to the size of an elephant's.
The worst part about going to the hospital is I had to tell so many people my penis is swollen. It was embarrassing.
I'm Dr. Hildebrandt. I understand you have some unusual swelling.
If you want to call this unusual.
I've never seen anything like this before. Never.
What do you think this is?
They took blood, they took urine, and they stuck a swab down there.
Do you have any prior history of STDs?
Doc, I'm clean.
The STD thing didn't come to mind. I just thought he probably got bit by something.
An allergic reaction?
Maybe, but this level of swelling is atypical for an allergic reaction. I mean, this is severe. Let me check on your labs. Excuse me.
You know, you want to really get to the bottom of it.
Well, he's allergic to everything.
And, yeah.
Pet dander, pollen. He's allergic to everything.
I'm sorry our vacation away from the hospital brought us right back to the hospital.
As long as I'm with you, babe, I don't care where I am.
We got the lab results and everything came back negative. No STDs, blood and urine all fine.
But it keeps swelling bigger. What does that mean?
That means I'm stumped. I have no idea what this is. To be honest, the only other time I saw something like this, it was a case of penile cancer.
Cancer?
And even that didn't look this bad. There's another condition called Fournier's gangrene, which can present similar symptoms. That's the flesh-eating bacteria.
I have my tonsils taken out, and now I have flesh-eating bacteria?
I'm like, oh my gosh, it's just too many unanswered questions.
Do you have diabetes or any history in your family?
No, none.
Because 99% of all Fournier's gangrene cases are from diabetes. So, no gangrene, no cancer. We're gonna have to call in a urologist.
all the swabs, blood tests, urine tests has came back negative, so the doctor didn't know what to do.
Excuse us.
At least we can rule those out.
In my mind, it's like I was broke. One of these doctors in here needs to learn how to fix it.
Tommy, this is Dr. William, the urologist. You'll be in good hands.
Thanks. Tommy, how you doing? Let's start at the beginning here. We've ruled out any STDs. Everything else looks normal.
Normal? This thing keeps getting bigger. It looks like an eggplant.
It's not important right now. But I do see you had your tonsils removed 3 days ago.
Yes, so?
Open up your mouth. Let me take a look.
The urologist didn't ask, you know, to see Tommy's member. He was more so wanting to know the history. You know, you had an idea that he was already on to something.
Oh, yeah. Have you had sex in the last 24 hours?
Yes, last night.
Did you give Stephanie oral sex before you had intercourse? I take that as a yes. Tommy, you have a yeast infection in your throat called thrush, or oral candidiasis. It's a fungus.
Oh my God. Does that mean I have a yeast infection in my mouth?
No, not you, just Tommy. Thrush is somewhat common after tonsillectomies. But what I think happened is, you gave your yeast infection to Stephanie during oral sex, then when he had intercourse, it infected your penis. So the yeast infection is actually what's causing the swelling.
How do I get a yeast infection?
I know those commercials make it sound like genital yeast infections can only affect women, but the fact is that men can be affected too, and when men get them, it can be bad.
So it's very important to realize that oral sex is not completely safe sex, so it behooves you to use some form of protection, and that can be a condom or a dental dam or a split open condom that will serve as a dental dam if you don't have one at home.
Nurse, could you hand me the lidocaine and the sterile tray? Thanks.
I felt stupid. This was a lot of drama. That was literally my fault. I thought I was doing her a favor.
So Tommy, since you're not circumcised, your foreskin is constricting the blood flow to the end of your penis. So if we don't apply manual pressure now to relieve the swelling, we may need to circumcise you.
Circumcise me? I don't want to leave here with all my man parts, Doc.
Okay.
In uncircumcised men, the foreskin can become irritated and swollen for a number of reasons. And if it's swollen and irritated for long enough, it can cut off the circulation to the head of the penis.
Because of the swelling, we need to do this right away. So I'm gonna numb the area first with a few injections.
I never have been stuck there, so I'm squeezing Stephanie's hand because I'm not afraid of needles. I'm just afraid of needles down there.
Spare with me, it's just gonna sting just a little.
It was like he was in labor. Like, he's like squeezing my hand like he's having contractions every time they put the needle in.
Just hold on, baby. It's almost over.
It was just like watching a man give birth.
Doing okay? Doing fine.
It's not a good feeling, guys. It's not a good feeling.
All right, you're all numbed up now and we can get started.
To relieve the pressure, he had to squeeze down there.
So, you gonna buy me dinner first, Doc?
Don't start. All right.
In cases where the foreskin is strangling the head of the penis, manual pressure over the area for 5 to 10 minutes can squeeze out all the fluid, relieving the pressure and preventing permanent damage. Now, as you can imagine, nobody in the ER is lining up to do that job.
You okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna hurt. Couple more. All right. Tommy, good job, man.
The doctor prescribed me antibiotics, and within a few days, it cleared up.
And Stephanie, you should be showing vaginal candidiasis symptoms fairly soon. You can treat your infection with an over-the-counter antifungal cream.
At the end of the day, sex did send us to the ER.
Tommy, Stephanie, nice to meet you.
But it made us closer and stronger.